Tēnā koutou katoa. My name is Nicole Price. I am the Technology Facilitator at Team Solutions, University of Auckland. Today I'm bringing you a screencast about design elements, and specifically some key messages related to the Level 1 Design Element Standard, Achievement Standard 91053, otherwise known as 1.10. The starting point when trying to understand the requirements of any standard is to have a good look at what the standard says. Ask yourself some very pertinent questions. For example, what is the learning objective at curriculum level 6? What do the indicators of progression say? And what other curriculum guidance is available? Achievement Standard 91053 comes from knowledge of design, which is part of design in technology. Design in technology refers to the practice undertaken to create a technological outcome, as well as to the description of the physical and functional nature of that outcome. You can find more specific information about design elements at curriculum level 6 on the TKI website. Go to the Teaching and Learning Guide for Technology, which is available at this address. Follow the link. What sets technological practice apart is its purposeful and productive nature. Outcomes are arrived at through a deliberate process of design, decision-making, production, and manufacturing, rather than by evolution. It is a fundamental component of the assessment that the students are able to show their own thinking, reasoning, and decision-making throughout their piece of work. Students are required to reflect and discuss on the elements of design within their own practice. They cannot do this without a clear understanding of the definition in relation to the broader context of the design field. Explanatory Note 4 from the Achievement Standard goes some way to list potential elements that could be used. Here is a link to a resource that unpacks some of the elements and describes their uses within the context of design. Also, my predecessor Leslie Pierce prepared a workshop on this particular standard in 2012. Her resources can be accessed through our technology wiki and also through the link on this page. To remember is that there is more to design elements than just consistency, repetition, alignment, and proximity. A potential barrier to student success has been teachers focusing their students on these four in particular, and just these four. The message is to encourage students to explore a range of design elements. Explanatory Note 4 suggests line, balance, shape, color, symmetry, strength, contrast, durability, and alignment are a sound starting point, but by no means are they a definitive list. Further feedback from the assessment reports for 2014 suggests that there are four main barriers to students achieving success within the standard. Number one, design elements are not discussed through the lens of subjective and objective. Number two, student research is not applied. Three, there is a lack of personal voice and opinion. And four, scaffolding can be limiting to student success. Let's unpack each of these in more detail and discuss the connotations further. Students can struggle to clearly articulate the differences between subjective and objective views. The definition of subjective is based on personal opinions, interpretations, and points of view, emotions, and judgment. Objective information or analysis is fact-based, measurable, and observable. There is room for both views in design. For the purposes of this standard, it is in the student's best interest to be able to discuss and compare aspects of them both. This leads on to point two, in that in 2014 the assessment report stated that some students did not provide an image or a screen dump or a printout of the outcome they were describing. Or perhaps to a lesser extent, they did provide black and white images when describing colour, or provided images that did not show a link to their own practice. Comment was also made that students described poorly designed outcomes, which did not give them enough scope to demonstrate understanding of the design elements. The students that tended to gain not achieved grades limited their critique to identifying the existence of an element or elements within a design, rather than how the design elements were applied. And they did not comment on the impact, both positive and negative, that the application of the design elements had on the outcome. The third point that I'd like to cover is that candidates who critiqued the application of design elements within existing products and outcomes relevant to their own technological practice and then applied this knowledge within the development and evaluation of their own outcomes continued to be more successful and were significantly more likely to gain merit and excellence grades. The requirement to describe the quality of an outcome is clearly stated within Explanatory Note 2 of the Achievement Standard. But what this means in relation to the assessment report is that some candidates' achievement was restricted due to different products being used to identify, describe the application of each design element. There was no coherence. These candidates were unlikely to advance beyond an achieved grade due to a lack of explanation and the use of a less robust compare and contrast model. That leads us on to our next point, where there is a suggestion that there was an inability to identify candidate voice and that the information that was produced within the student reports was not contextualized nor used to inform candidate opinion within their own technological practice in later sections of the report. This restricted candidates from accessing higher grades. Leading on from the previous slide, let me unpack that a little bit more. These submissions were often template-based with limited scope for divergent thought and were regularly repetitive. While templates are a good way to brainstorm and order thoughts, they should not be a definitive structure for collecting evidence, as students often write to fill boxes and tend not to link to their own experience. Good reports that were not scaffolded often analyzed two or more existing products through a compare and contrast model, then linked these comments to a student's own technological outcome. This allowed for the research to inform development of the student's outcome, and it also enabled students to justify their design decisions. Leading on from the last slide, students who utilized templates and teacher-led activities often produced repetitive text, and many duplicated the same content and level of evidence for different products. In addition to this, it was often very difficult to differentiate between information provided by the teacher, downloaded, group work, and that produced by the individual candidate. For this reason, you can see that the use of student voice shows a greater link to student authenticity. When supporting students' report writing, it's really important to consider that evidence should increase in complexity, depth, and following the literacy step-ups as the report is developed. What do I mean by this? Well, for example, the wording in the achievement standard states that for achieved, the students must demonstrate understanding through describing certain elements. For merit, students must demonstrate in-depth knowledge by explaining certain elements. And for excellence, students must demonstrate comprehensive knowledge through discussing certain elements. It's really important to unpack what they might look like. Suggestions. Well, as far as suggestions go towards helping your students gain success, I would recommend considering some of the following. Setting the context around student interest and ability. Engage personalized learning in order to promote individual student voice. Use a wide range of evidence to support diverse learning styles, student collaboration, and evidence collection. Perhaps consider literacy to support the standard. A good example of this is a compare and contrast strategy. It is a good way to get students thinking beyond their own opinions on the elements. Asking the questions, how is this the same or different from the last example, and getting the student to elaborate on the because sitting behind their perception is getting them to explain and discuss, therefore extending their initial answers to merit an excellence level. That brings us to the end of this screencast. I hope you have got something out of it. This screencast is part of a series where my colleagues will be covering 1.5 and 1.6 as well. They are available along with other webcasts and PLD resources on our technology wikis at these addresses. This screencast was done as part of the Secondary Student Achievement PLD contract funded by the Ministry of Education.